In this session, let us discuss various types of game mode. You must have played many games, different types of games, and these types can be used in educational games also. Let's see how. There are adventure games, business games, board games, logic games. There are puzzles, there are word games, there are strategy games, card games, combat games, and simulation games. Most of these words must be familiar to you because you might have played this kind of games in your regular life. But now let's see how the same types can be used for educational purpose. You all know that in adventure games, player assumes the role of the main character. There is some interactive story and there is exploration, there is puzzle solving. Character goes on doing adventures in this environment. These games are usually of narrative type, and the learner has to focus on finding solutions to a problem situation. For example, the character needs to do adventures, find out many ways, and finally acquire a hidden treasure. So, player always needs to explore. Whenever there are hurdles, whenever there are situations of adventures, there can be learning problems asked. For example, if a learner is presented with a mathematical problem, the door will not open till the problem is solved. So the learner will solve that problem, the door will open, and it will lead the learner to the other section. Now here, learner goes on acquiring skills of problem solving because the learner wants to reach to the treasure. You must have played business games, which are paper-based or card-based games. But here, there are many online games available, which are business games to be played by the learners to solve problems. Now, these problems are business-related problems, and learners as a team also can go on solving. So it might be individual game or group game. But most importantly, all values of managing a business get developed here. There may be some economical features. There may be some finance rules, management rules, which are learnt and followed by the learner so as to play this game. So, in this game, there may be competition or there may be teamwork. So we can also encourage cooperative learning by providing teamwork or team game facility. You must have played chess, snake and ladder, monopoly. These are board games. So on actual board, we generally throw dice. We have many pieces which we place, move, remove. Now, in educational games, there may be a virtual board provided on computer. There may be some rules to be followed. There may be many objects to be moved. For example, if there is an environmental game, then there may be some objects placed. There may be dice to throw, and there will be a situation. Whatever action, decision the learner is taking about that situation, accordingly, the learner will be able to move forward. There can be some simple board games or there can be strategic board games. In strategic board games, the decision of the learner is very crucial so as to move. Let us take an example of snake and ladder. If the learner takes decision that I will cut the tree if it is coming in the way of my garden, then the snake will swallow the learner. If learner says that I will beautify the tree and maintain it inside my garden as it is, then the learner may get a ladder to jump. This is how board games help learners acquire some skills or improve their decision-making ability. Let's see this game. It's a seesaw. And the question is, which object is the heaviest among all provided objects? Here the learner has to use logic that there are two objects and those two are equal to the cone object. So the cone must be the heaviest object. Objects on the seesaw keep on changing and every time learner needs to click on the heaviest object. Here learner uses logic and also learns geometry in the process of learning. So here player uses logic to solve some problems. Learner learns to acquire some information, then use logical thinking on the basis of that information and comes out with a solution. So data gathering ability and problem solving ability get developed in the process of learning. So after collecting information, learner learns to analyze data. This analysis is helpful in solving maths problems or even in reading comprehension. So logic games are to be used mainly for mathematics, mainly for reading comprehension, and maybe also for solving some social problems. You can see that there is an entire resource of many logic games. There is one game from this pool which we will see. You must be familiar with this game. You always give puzzles to each other. And this puzzle is a bit common puzzle. There is a jackal, a sheep, and a vegetable. At a time, only one object can be carried from one bank to the other bank of the river. You actually can do it and solve it. So now, the sheep is being carried. If you leave the sheep and come back and carry jackal, then jackal will eat the sheep. So, if you are carrying vegetable, you have to leave vegetable and bring the sheep back and then carry the jackal. Learners learn this by practicing, actually applying, and they can see what is happening in this game. Isn't that interesting? You must have solved many puzzles. Jigsaw cards is a typical puzzle game. Here, the entire world map is given in jigsaw pieces and learners can move these pieces and form all continents. So puzzles can challenge your creativity and resourcefulness also. You need to be very imaginative to join those pieces and you must be aware of the content so that you can actually adjust the puzzle and say that yes, I know positions of various countries, continents, and I can create world map. So here you are given many pieces to join. In puzzles, you join pieces or you solve some crosswords, but you use your logic, you use your creativity, and you use your resourcefulness. Recognition of pattern and order sequence knowledge of those patterns is important in puzzles. Let's see what this is. There are some alphabets and using those alphabets, the learner needs to create as many words as possible. So some alphabets are provided. You can see that three words are already created by the learner. And now the fourth word, ear, is being constructed. So the words once constructed will sit on those books and we will see how many words a learner can create from these given alphabets. This is a word game. So, word game is a game where the player is challenged with a variety of activities where learner requires recognition, production, and analysis of words. These word games generally help learners to improve their vocabulary. They learn spellings, they learn various formation of words, and sometimes you can also provide meanings of these words. The other type is strategy games. Games that focus on the ability to make decisions that determine the outcome are strategy games. So here, outcomes are already decided, but so as to reach to that goal or to achieve that outcome, learner needs to take wise decisions. Here, a scenario is created and a problem is presented. So in that particular scenario, learner goes on solving that problem and learner needs to take some decisions, use some strategy to solve the problem. So the learner has to select one, since each strategy gives a different result. So for every strategy, for every decision, a particular result is always decided. Isn't it difficult to decide and design this kind of strategy games? Typical example of card game is playing cards. In reality, you must have played many card games. But when it comes to educational game, now these cards are changed into some educational content. So here, learner is playing cards or something similar to these cards for learning various skills. Flashcards, flip cards can also be used along with playing cards. This particular game gives chance to the learner to detect similar words. So here, learner learns the words, learner learns spellings, and visual ability is also developed. You all know that children love combat games. They learn by playing wars. They are in a hurry to win. They are in a hurry to overcome enemies. So the games where the primary focus of the play concerns the player to be armed with guns or other weapons is a combat game. Truly speaking, when we provide this war kind of environment to the learner, we are actually deviating learner from educational values. But there are some combat games such as Math Blaster or Science Blaster which has some characteristics of traditional combat games, but they are in milder form. And after some war, some combating, there are educational contents provided to the learners. Have you ever dreamed as a child to enter into an operation theater and do the real operation? I know it's never possible because the skills need to be acquired. But how's about a virtual environment, a virtual operation theater where learner can enter and do heart surgery also? When the learner is put in such situations which are in reality not possible or feasible, they are put into simulation. So this is simulation mode of game, which is very interesting. Here, the learner has entered into the operation theater. Learner has selected scalpel. The doctor is guiding learner to cut, and slowly the learner will complete heart surgery entirely. This is another simulation game, which is about farming. There is always a typical situation when urban students are taught about farming and they hardly know anything. If they don't have their own house in rural area, for them, all procedures of farming are actually abstract. They get to see tractors only in photographs or in movies. But here is a game where entire farming can be done virtually. Simulation mode of game is based on realism. We provide environment as real as possible. Here, the learner has to develop a skill where there are choices to make, there are decisions to take in the environment which is real-like. So, to work in this real-like environment, the learner needs to develop some skills, decide on some choices. And this environment helps learner to acquire some skills which may be developed and then applied in the real situation when the real environment is provided. For example, before a pilot is put in the real plane, there is always a simulated environment where the player, the learner, the pilot learns various strategies, various objects of a flight. the entire cockpit can be simulated. Similarly, there are many science experiments which can be done by the learner in simulated environment. For example, wherever there is risk of blast, learner can do those experiments safely in simulated mode. So, after going through all these types, do you feel that if we provide this kind of environment to our students, where they go on playing, they go on achieving outcomes, and they don't even realize that they have learned something? They are put in a simulation and they can play with various variables within reality may not be possible for the learner to play with. This kind of game environments will really help learners to acquire new skills of life, whichever are not possible only in the four walls, or whichever are not possible in tutorial mode, where again they are just given content to read and they can solve some MCQs or multiple choice questions. Let's think of such games for educational purpose. Thank you.